to be lifted and refreshed. You gotta turn, turn your radio.
Joyous Radio, Joyous Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, oh, I keep on.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and be glad in this day. We thank God for another day in the land of the living. We thank Him for His holy, written, precious words. Today, Lord, we're going to stand in Your words because the entrance of Your word give us light. We're going to use that light as a guide to our path and a lamp to our feet. We thank You for this blessed and prosperous time. We thank You for Your word that is still alive and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. This is the Christian family. We invite you to get something to write with and something to write on. This is Choice Radio 92.9 FM. Your life, your salvation, your choice. Let us pray.
Hallelujah. Father, on tonight, Lord God, we thank You once again, Lord God. We thank You, Lord God, that we're able to come to Your throne of grace once again, Lord God. We thank You, Lord God, for just You being who You say You are, Lord God. Father God, I just ask You for everyone that's out there in radio land, Father God, that's on the internet, Lord God, to let them have receptive heart, Lord God, and listening ears onto Your word, Lord God. We take nothing for granted, Lord God, and we just thank You for 92.9, Lord God. We just thank You, Lord God, for You found us faithful, Lord God, to come on, Father God, to minister onto Your peoples, Lord God. Father God, on tonight, we just love You. We glorify You. We exalt You because of who You are, Lord God. And we love You and we praise You in no other name but in Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen and amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Amen. This is indeed, again, a wonderful opportunity and privilege. We don't take this lightly. We don't take the word of God lightly. We always have to go back to some of my favorite scripture. My people, not people, but my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Think about the Apostle Paul. We always have to go back and look at these mighty men of God that he is could be considered a synonym for the new covenant, from the book of Romans to the book of Hebrews, the Apostle Paul. He adopted Timothy as a son in the faith, and he said to Timothy, from a child that was known the Holy Scripture was able to make thee wise, but yet he said to Timothy, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of God. So we could wrongly divide the word of God. We're going to look at something here tonight, spend a few hours looking at this, maybe and tell the Holy Spirit tells us to stop. Maybe just do a short part of it. This is excerpts of series that we did some time ago. And some of these things that I put together, you know, every time somebody tell me something, because I look at those folks that went on to Jonestown, Guyana, and those in Waco, Texas, the Heaven Gate cult in California, what's wrong with these folks that would make them follow somebody without asking questions? What would make them terminate life at a very early age with just listening, just blind obedience to somebody without even following the word? I think we should start adopting like the Berean Christian. They said they search the scriptures out daily to see if this thing will do. So we need to search the scripture out daily. As I say, if you're living in a particular neighborhood and you don't like it, you can move. If you get married, it's not working out, it's not the best, but you can get a divorce before somebody get hurt. You know, you want a job and it's not paying you well, you could move on to our next job. You could make some changes. You arrive in hell, you're not coming back. You arrive in hell, you're not coming back. Couldn't Amen. Say, I'm sorry, I want to go back. I taught the bishop, I taught the apostle. You taught, there's no time for taughting. You have to know now, my people. Didn't say people, my people.
Amen.
And you know, I look at these things over the years. I look at this thing about the church that I've been and many churches that I fellowship with over the years, you know. In the early years of the ministry, I used to go every week. I'll go to a different church before we had a church home. Every week, go to a different church and learn some stuff and something you didn't learn anything at all. But you go and hear what people have to say about God. And sometimes you look at some of these things, some of these churches go, sometimes the word was that Jesus Christ in many, many places. I've been, I don't know where you've been, but I've been there and I take a survey across some of these churches that I've been to. And you always find the name of Jesus always being conspicuously Amen. Absent. You know, you go to some churches, no Bible at all. No Bible. Nobody's required to bring a Bible. Sometimes we coming up on Sunday morning, I tell my wife, I say, look at that. People go into church, walk into each church, nobody have a Bible in their hand. You know, when you, what's dangerous about that is that when you Amen. Come from church, you could not say what the Bible says. It said this in Matthew, in Mark said this, in the book of Acts said this, in Romans said, you couldn't say that because you don't have a Bible. All you could say is the pastor say. The pastor say. No, what does the Bible say? Your Amen. Faith not supposed to be the pastor, your faith supposed to be the word of God. And that's what's going to make it work. If the pastor saying what God said, well, then we might have some business. But Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. I would put that a different way, follow Christ as I follow Christ. You know, and you have to be very careful. This is one thing we Bible talk about long life, but also talk about eternal life. You know how long it's eternal? And, you know, we put all these things together. As you look at this thing over the years, get all this information, go back to the Bible and find what it have to say about this, what it have to say about the other. So I want to look at something here tonight. Turn in your Bibles to the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 18, and let's start up there tonight. And hear what God has to say to us in his holy, written, precious words. Matthew chapter 18, I have a red light edition, reading from the traditional King James, and hear what God has to say to us. Matthew chapter 18, and we want to look at two verses in Matthew chapter 18, verses 19 and 20. Matthew chapter 18, get something to write with and something to write on. I wanted to leave this program and say, the pastor say, pastor didn't say, the Bible say. That's very dangerous. The pastor could miss it because he don't know it all. Paul say, follow me as I follow Christ. So follow the Bible. Hear what the Bible says. Be as the Berean Christian. Search the scriptures out daily to see if these things were so. Matthew 18, look at those two verses. Look at 19 and 20. Again, I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done of my Father which is in heaven. Look at the 20th verse. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. You notice the gathering together. You notice what name is important there? My name. They must gather in his name. Look at that 20th verse. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, if his name is not there, well, the gathering is doesn't make any sense. So if you go to a church and his name is not mentioned, his name is not lifted up, if I be lifted up, I'll draw men. He's not there. Look at it. Let's read one more time. Again, where I say, until look at verse 19, that where two or three are gathered in, touching anything, they shall ask, it shall be done of them, my Father, which is in heaven. Verse 20, for where two or three are gathered together in my name. So if his name is not there, and you're gathering, and his name is not there, you're gathering in vain. See, little things like that we can let pass. What the purpose of you gathering? Look at one more time. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, they are in the midst. We want to title this miniseries, The Name. How important is the name? And how that name is conspicuously absent wherever you turn. Look at something else in Mark chapter 16. The name. What's so important in the name? We'll find out. Mark, M-A-R-K is Mark. Chapter 16, where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst. So if you didn't gather in his name, he's not there. What are the purposes of you gathering? He's not mentioned. No Bible is being read. His name is not mentioned. And when my children was younger, I remember we take them to church when they was much younger, and give each one a piece of paper and them to write. Every time you hear them mention Jesus, mark it down. And many, many, many places called churches where they never mention the name of Jesus. The children had nothing to write. I say, when time they mention Jesus, if Joseph miss it, maybe Randolph will pick it up. If Randolph miss it, then Ronald will probably pick it up. Go some places, never mention the name of Jesus. Look at this, Mark, M-A-R-K, Mark, chapter 16, pick it up with the 15th verse. And he said unto them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believe and is baptized shall be saved, he that believe and shall be damned. These signs shall follow them that believe in my name. In my name, they shall cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues. They take up any serpent, if they drink any deadly thing, in my name, it shall not hurt them. Lay hands on the sick, in my name, or they shall recover. My name. So if the name isn't there, the devil will go, in my name, they shall cast out devils. So if the name isn't there, Jesus, the devil isn't going anywhere. The name, Mark, 16, that verse, I got 15 again. I said unto them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. So wherever you go, you're going to need that name. In Africa, in Asia, in Europe, in the Caribbean, in the Americas. Go into all the world, carry that name with you. He that believe and is baptized shall be saved in the name. And believe not shall be damned. These signs shall follow them that believe in my name. In my name. In my name. Can you see that? My name. Big John chapter 16, the name. The name. Big John chapter 16, I have a red light edition reading from the traditional King James. and hear what God have to say to us in his holy, written, precious words. Hallelujah. The name that is conspicuously absent as we go through life, the name. Without the name, you gather together in his name. His name is not there, you're gathering is in vain. In my name they shall cast out devil. Look at Big John 16, look at verse 23 and 24. In that day you shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever shall ask the Father in my name, he'll give it you. Hitherto you have asked nothing in my name. Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. My name. So if you ask the Father for anything, and you didn't ask in Jesus' name, you're not getting it. And maybe the reason why many prayers are not answered, because his name is not involved. Look at that one more time. Look at that. In that day you shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I swear to tell the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. I say unto you, whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, house, husband, wife, children, healing, money, deliverance, whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it to you. Hitherto you have asked nothing in my name. Ask. But when you ask, have to be in his name. Have to be in his name. You see, and sometimes we talk a lot about God, did God this and that, you have to talk this and talk that, but never mention the name. Whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, where two or three gather together in my name. My name. They shall cast out devils in my name. My name is not there, it's not going to work. My name is not there, it's not going to work. Look at those two verses again. In that day you shall ask me nothing. That day when he go to be at the right hand of the Father, he was speaking prophetically there. He hasn't gone back yet after his death, burial, and resurrection. When he gone back, because when Jesus was here on earth, he was the entire body of Christ. He had the spirit without measure, and he operated in the fivefold ministry as an apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, and teacher. He operated all there, so he had it all. You have no apostles that follow him, the disciples that follow him didn't pray for anything. Anything they wanted to go to Jesus. Wanted wine to go to Jesus. Wanted bread to go to Jesus. Here's a blind man, go to Jesus. Here's a deaf man, go to Jesus. Here's a dead person, go to Jesus. But he said, come in that day when I'm going back to be at the right hand of the Father. Take up that new position. In that day you shall ask the Father in my name. Though if you ask the Father in my name, is that he's not going to give it to you. That check is not signed, it could be returned to sender. Can you see that? In that day you shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, he shall give it you. Hitherto you have asked nothing in my name. Ask, I shall be given you. To joy may be full. Ask. But you have to ask in the name of Jesus. The name. The name. The name. Look at some in the book of Luke. Let's see where that name come from. Let's see that name where it come from. Luke chapter 1. And let's see what he have to say about the name. How this name get introduced into the earth realm? Let's see how this name is introduced in the earth realm. Hallelujah. Now the Holy Ghost is given credit for writing this book. He's really the author of this book. Holy men of God speak as the Spirit of God was upon them. So this is not their writing. This is the Holy Spirit working through them. Hallelujah. Jesus said the apostle that he had chosen, he spoke to them through the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost is really the author of this book. Luke chapter 1, look at the 26th verse. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin name was Mary. And the angel came in unto and said, Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled, and saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou shalt find favor with God. Behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. So this angel, Gabriel, come from the presence of God, come down here to this city of Nazareth in Galilee, to speak to this virgin, and bring that name all the way from the third heaven, and bring it there and give it to her, and said, This child shall be called Jesus. Can you see that? Luke chapter 2. The name Jesus, come all the way from heaven with that name Jesus. Luke chapter 2, the name. God have nothing better to do but to send an angel all down, one of his archangel, Gabriel, to come down here to speak to a virgin, to bring a name, Jesus. Luke chapter 2, and look at the 21st verse. Luke chapter 2, the name, the name. Whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it you. cast out devils in my name, the devil is not going to move until in Jesus' name. If you gather together in my name, I'm there. The name. And the reason why he's not in many places, because he's not there. His name is not there. He's not invited. Luke chapter 2, look at verse 21. And when any days were accomplished for the circumcision of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was so name of the angel before he was conceived in the womb. So they bring that name all that it had that name before she conceived, it had that name. And they bring that name down him and give it unto Mary. And when he was went for circumcision, as the man of the law was, give him that name, Jesus. Let's see something about this name, Jesus. How important is the name Jesus? Philippians chapter 2. And let's hear what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious word. The name. The name. What's so important in the name? Hallelujah. The name. If you gather together in my name, this name come all the way from heaven. Angel bring it all. The angel Gabriel bring this from all the way from the third heaven. Come down here and give it this name. Look at something about this name. Hallelujah. Philippians chapter 2. And look at the 9th verse. Wherefore God also highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow of things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God. So he gave him a name that is above every name. It's above sickness, poverty, loneliness, debt, any name. In my name they shall cast out devils. My name gathered together in my name. Whatsoever he has the Father in my name, that's the only name could get you into heaven. My name. God has highly exalted him. Look at this. Wherefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name that's above every name. You don't have no name higher than Jesus.
Amen.
You don't have no name higher than Jesus.
Amen.
Can you read? That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth. So in three worlds, they have to bow to that name, Jesus Christ. Come all the way from the third heaven, bring it down and give it to Mary. Child shall be called Jesus. God has highly exalted him and given him a name that's above every name. That at that name, every knee, black knee, white knee, young knee, old knee, rich knee, poor knee, born in this country knee, and born abroad knee, every knee have to bow to this name.
Amen.
Every knee have to bow to this name. Look at it. The name, every knee should bow to these things in heaven, things on earth, and things under the earth. And every tongue should confess. And every tongue should confess. And every tongue should confess that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Quite a bit of revelation inside of you.
Amen.
Quite a bit of revelation inside of there. Give him a name that's above every knee have to bow to this name. Buddha have to bow to this name. Hare Krishna have to bow to this name. Muhammad have to bow to this name. Confucius have to bow to this name. Money have to bow to this name. Sickness, everything have to bow to this name. Highly exalt him. Give him a name that's above every name. That at this name, every knee must bow. And many, many, many places we go, you never hear the name Jesus.
Amen.
One thing that triggered this study, the name many years ago, is that we were doing outreach in 42nd Street Port Authority area. And there were two young men who was going to take their lives. Remember those two young men going to jump
yes.
on the train line, they're going to take their lives. And my team was out there ministering, and they were saying, any man in Christ is a new creature, all things are passed away, behold, all things become new. Greater is he who is the new. And they was talking and walking through the crowd and just reading all these scriptures and so on. These two young men stopped in their tracks, and they say, if we hear them say the right thing, we're going to stop and we're going to go with these men. Say, you don't have to live like that, come with us. And they're just walking through the crowd, greater is he who's in me. Any man in Christ is a new creature, all things are past when they're just going through scripture. And they say they listen, because if they don't hear the right word, both of them going to jump on the train and take their lives together, two cousins. And another brother comes through from throughout the crowd and saying, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. And they say, that's what we want to hear. And those two young men, we picked them up at Port Authority area, brought them back to the ministry. One of them stayed there, become a house leader, met his wife there and got married. The other one stayed for about 6 months and then left. But the other one stayed with us for many years. Met his wife there, married there, and started a family right there. He had was taking a life. What they wanted to hear, Jesus. Greater is he who is in me than he is in the world. I can do all things through Christ. He that begin a good work will see it, perform it till the day of Lord Jesus. Read out all the scripture. They say, if we hear the writing, we will stop. And one of the brothers walking through the crowd might have been kept Charlie Cosby, because I think he was head of that team. Jesus is Lord! Jesus is Lord! Jesus is Lord! Mm. And they stopped in the track. That's what they wanted to hear.
Yes.
I have this on my file somewhere in the office. This young man gave his testimony. He was dying with an incurable blood disease. And the doctors tell him there's no cure back then in the 40s, no cure for this disease. I don't think they have any care for it today either. Incurable blood disease. They went to every doctor everywhere, tried everything, and they say he's not going to live to be 16 years of age. So this is like we started with 12, 13, 14 years just going on. Just get progressively worse over the years. So come a day and the spirit leave the body, get onto the body. So he feel the death just tightening his claws around his neck, and he dying, and get out of his body. And he start plunging into hell. And he said, I'm a member of the church. I was baptized in water. I'm a member of the church. I was baptized. And he keep going down, went down, leave his body, come back into his body. Leave his body a second time, go down. I was a member of the church. I was baptized in water. I read granny Bible. Leave his body, come back in the second time. Leaving the third time, going down, start screaming out. And somewhere along the scream, Jesus! Hand take him and put him right back inside his body. And he lived to tell that he lived to be, he died some years ago, 86 years of age. But all I remember the church, I was baptized in water. I read granny Bible. Yeah, that will save you.
Mm-mm.
You know? Last time he just screaming everything that he could think about. And somewhere along the he mentioned Jesus. And a hand just pull him and put him back inside his body. These two young men are going to take their life. Greater is he who's in me than hearing all that. That's scripture, right?
Mm-hmm.
But they want to hear something. And one of the young men walking through the crowd, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. Pick up these two young men, receive Christ Jesus, and the rest is history. So here I give him a name that's above every name, that at that name, every knee must bow, beings in heaven, beings on earth, and beings in every tongue have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You don't do it now, you're going to have to do it in the other world. You're going to have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Can you see that? Look at the book of Colossians, chapter 2. The name, Colossians chapter 2. I see what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious words. Colossians chapter 2. Look at the 15th verse. Having small principalities and powers, may assure them openly and triumphant in them over them in it. So here Jesus defeat the powers of darkness in hell when he went into hell. Having spoiled principalities and powers, making assure them openly. Now what is them name? You have to explain this, but they make assure them openly. Well, when David killed Goliath, he cut off his head and he took his head and he running all through the city and showing all the people that this is Goliath's head, making assure of him. He defeat principality and power, make assure and spoil principality. Well, when you go to war with a country, defeated country, you take all the wealth out of the country and say they spoil the country. So here Jesus, having spoiled principalities and power, made assure them openly, triumphant in them over them in it. So he defeat principality and power in the lower realm. So we see that God gave him a name that's above every name, that at that name every knee must bow. Here he spoiled principalities and power when he went to the lower part. Look at the next one. Hebrews chapter 1, the name. The name. The name that's above every name. And you go to many places, this name is conspicuously absent. Mm-hmm. The name. The name. The name. The name. The name. Look at Hebrews 1. Look at the fourth verse. Put your finger in the fourth verse. Being made so much better than them, than the angels, he had by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Being made so much better than the angels, and he had by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. So Jesus get that name in three areas: by bestowal, by conquest, and by inheritance. He inherited this name. Look at verse 4 again. Being made so much better than the angels, as he had by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. So you get a name in three areas: by conquest, defeat principality and power, by inheritance, and by bestowal. God has highly exalted him and given him a name that's above every name. We have something we need to shout about, these things you never hear. In some places you go, you never hear them talk about God and God this and God speak a word in life and God this, and never hear him talk about Jesus. Never hear him talk about Jesus. And if you see, he want to get something across to you, You know, every knee have to bow to this name, the name of Jesus, to this name. Beings in heaven, beings on earth, and beings under the earth. He defeat principality and power. He inherit this name. Three areas he get a name: bestorial, conquest, and inheritance. More excellent name than they. Look at the book of Acts chapter 4 and see what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious words. Acts chapter 4. Glory to God. God is a good God, and we thank him for his holy, written, precious words. Acts chapter 4, look at the 12th verse. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. So anybody who want to get saved in Asia, in Africa, in Europe, throughout the Americas, all the islands of the sea, anybody who want to get saved have to come to this name. There's no other name. So if you're out there and you didn't confess this name, you're not saved. If your church doesn't keep talking about Jesus, 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 Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, maybe you're not saved. Maybe you're in the wrong church. Look at that. There's none other. Look at this. Neither there is salvation in any other, for there's none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Well, salvation is number one, because the gifts of the Spirit come after salvation. Everything else come after salvation. Baptism and the Holy Ghost come after salvation. Salvation is number one. There's only one baptism. That's one of the saved. Baptism of the Holy Ghost. Where the Holy Ghost is the baptizer, you are the candidate, and the family is the element that you baptize into the family. To baptize means to be submerged, to be immersed, to bury, to cover. To be baptized into the family. So there's no other name under heaven you can be saved. If you listening to this on radio, you viewing this on radio, and the time you think you're going to be leaving your body, but call out to Jesus. Call out to Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, I'm sorry. Jesus, you're right. I'm wrong. Jesus. Third time he leave his body going down. Somebody scream out somewhere, Jesus, help me, Jesus. Went back into his body. Two young men going to take their life. They're hearing everything else. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. And they stop in their tracks, pick them up, brought them back to the ministry, receive Jesus. The rest is history. Jesus is Lord. Many times you're saying a lot of things, you think you're saying it. No, you're not. That could be a trick of the devil. Keep you away. Keep the name Jesus. Keep it out of the church. Don't talk about that. Keep it out of the church. Three areas: by bestorial, by conquest, by inheritance. There is no other name under heaven whereof man must be saved. Look at Acts chapter 8, and look at the Ethiopian eunuch coming to Ethiopia, coming from Ethiopia to Jerusalem for the worship. And look at this story. Take your time and get something to write with and think about it. And ask yourself, am I saved? If Jesus should come right now, if I should close my name, am I absolutely sure, am I 100% sure that I'm going to heaven? If you have to pause and think about it, you're not saved. If somebody should walk up there and ask you, you're male or female, and you don't know, well, you're not. If you don't know whether you're male or female, well, then you're not. So if you have to think about salvation, I don't know whether you're not saved. And that day could come, you end up in hell, and you're asking yourself, what am I doing here? And that day, many are going to say to me, Lord, Lord. Lord, Lord. Too late. 10 virgin, 5 wise, 5 foolish. Too late. Too late. You're not coming back. Scream all you want, you're not coming back. This is very important. Everything else is secondary. Everything else has no dairy. This is first, primary. Salvation. Look at this story here with the Ethiopian eunuch. And let's look at this story. Just read it and listen to this. Acts chapter 8, pick it up in 26th verse. And the angel of the Lord speak unto Philip and say, arise and go down towards the south unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem unto Gaza, which is desert. And he arose and went, and behold, a man of Ethiopia, eunuch of great authority under Candace, the queen of Ethiopia, who had charge of all her treasures, had come to Jerusalem for to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot, and read Isaiah the prophet. Then the Spirit said unto Philip, go near and join thyself to this chariot. And Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah, and said unto him, understandest what thou readest? And he said, how can I, lest some man should guide me? And he desired that Philip would come up and sit with him. And the place of the scripture where he read was this: he was like a sheep led to the slaughter like a lamb dumb before a shearer. He opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, his judgment was taken away. And who shall declare his generation, for his life was taken from the earth? And the eunuch answered and said to Philip, said I, pray thee, of whom speak the prophet this, of himself or some other? And Philip opened his mouth and began to the same scripture to preach unto him, Jesus. Take him away from Isaiah, bring him down to Jesus. Look at verse 36. And as they went on their way, they came to a certain water. And the eunuch said, see, here's water. What do hinder me to be baptized? Philip said, if thou believest with all thy heart, thou mayest. And he answers, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
Oh, yes.
I believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God. All that prophet Isaiah reading, Jesus Christ is the Son of God. All that, Philip, take him right to Jesus. Philip, take him right to Jesus. If you believe that Jesus Christ is the name that's above every name. Take him to Jesus. I believe that Jesus Christ, Son of God, now you're saved. Now we could baptize in water. You see that? Numero uno, take him right to Jesus. And if you believe that Jesus is Lord, we got it made. Look at the book of Romans. The book of Romans, chapter 10. This is Choice Radio 92.9 FM, your life, your salvation, your choice. This is the Christian family. Get something to write with and something to write on. Telephone number over there is 347-533-4271. Here in the studio, 347-663-8638. Romans, chapter 10. Give you a name that's above every name. There's no other name on earth where you're going to be saved. If you get saved, money couldn't save you, color skin couldn't save you, education couldn't save you, nobody else could save you. This is the only name that could save you. No other name. No other name. This is the name. Romans chapter 10, pick it up at verse 9. The name. Verse 9, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with thy heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession made unto salvation. For the scripture said, whosoever believeth in him shall not be ashamed. For there is no difference between the Jews or the Greek. The same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. Look at the 13th verse. Put your finger on the 13th verse. Look at the 13th verse. 13 verse, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever, black, white, male, female, educated, uneducated, born in this country, born, whosoever. This level everybody. Nobody's going through no special door. Nobody have no special access. This is it. There's no other name under heaven where man must be saved. This is the name. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. The Ethiopian eunuch call upon the name. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Yes, now you're saved. The name. Everything else is secondary. This is first. The name. You're not calling the name, you're going to get yourself into trouble. You could end up on the other side and say, I didn't know. Plunging into hell. Just somewhere stream out from all inside of him. Jesus! Drive right back in his body. Jesus. I read Granny Bible. I'm a member of the church. I was baptized in water. They can't save you. Plunging straight into hell. Jesus. Acts chapter 3, and let's see what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious word. The name. Acts chapter 3, and look what God is saying to us here, the early church getting off the ground. Acts chapter 3, and let's speak about verse 1. Acts chapter 3, the name, let's speak about verse 1. Now Peter and John went up together unto the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. A certain man lame from his mother's womb, who they carry and lay daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask the alms of them that enter in the temple. Who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, ask an alms. Peter fastened his eyes upon him, and John said, look on us. And he gave heed, expecting to receive something of them. Look at verse 6. Peter said, silver and gold have I none, such as I give I thee in the name. You see, I don't have silver and gold, but I got the name. Such as I have. Look at verse 6. Peter said, silver and gold have I none, such as I give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up from the rock. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle were on restrained strength. He leaping and stood up and walked and entered into the temple, walking, leaping, and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. Can you see that? In the name. Man crippled from his mother womb, nothing could do with the name. He probably went to doctors everywhere.
Amen.
He probably went to therapy many, many places. He probably went anywhere trying to get to solve that problem. Mm-hmm. Couldn't work. From his mother womb. From his mother womb. From his mother womb. And if you go a little further on in chapter 4 and verse 22, you see the man was above 40 years old whom this miracle of healing was. So he was above 40 years. So from time of child, above 40. So he might have been 42, 45 years, somewhere there, above 40 years. You look at chapter 4 and verse 22, you tell you he was above 40 years. So here Peter says, silver and gold have I none, such as I have. Such as I have. Give him right to the name. He has the PIN number for this name. Given to him. Peter said, silver and gold have I none, such as I give I. In the name, if we could just locked in on the name. There's no other name under heaven. Whosoever call upon the name. If you get in my name. Whatsoever you ask the Father in my name. My name. My name. My name. My name. Whatsoever you ask the Father in my name. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. No Jesus Christ. He didn't say the name of Peter or Paul or James or John. Jesus. He didn't say Buddha or Hare Krishna or Muhammad. Jesus. Jesus. Such as I have give I thee in the name of Jesus. Well, if Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, if it worked back then, it ought to work today. Mm-hmm. Or then he changed, because Malachi 3 and verse 6, I am the Lord that change it not. He never changes. So if it worked back there, and that's the early church, we've been around 2,000 years later, I wonder if Jesus decreased in value or in power. I don't think so. I don't think so. What happened to the church over the years? The church lost its way. It got involved in religion and denomination, customs and tradition, and put Jesus out of the way. And Jesus is conspicuously absent most places you go. Hard pressed to hear Jesus, to talk about Jesus is a rarity. Can you see that? Such as I have in the name. In the name. And some places we go, you hardly hear anything about talk about God, and God do this, and God this, and God the other. Which God? Satan is the God of this world. Which God are you speaking about? When we do other segment, we will see who have a right to use the name. We're not talking that tonight. We're not looking at that tonight. In the name, such as I give in the name. In the name. In the name. Look at Acts chapter 16. Glory to God. Acts chapter 16. The name. Ain't nothing happening without the name. There's nothing happening without the name. You gather, it must be in my name. If you want the gift to manifest, you have to gather in his name. And you want the spiritual gifts to manifest, word of wisdom, word of knowledge, special faith, healing, miracles, discerning of spirit, prophecy, tongues, and interpretation of tongues. Want those gifts, you have to be gathered in his name. The reason why the gift doesn't manifest, because they didn't gather in his name. And sometimes not authorized to gather. We can look at that in the next segment. That's why it doesn't manifest. Then you never call the name. You never call the name. He give him a name that's about that name, every knee. No other name under heaven, my man. You can't get saved by no other name. Your money couldn't save you. Your education couldn't save you. Your color skin couldn't save you. Where you were born, your geographical location couldn't save you. Only this name. This is the only name that could save you. Jesus. Jesus. Whosoever call upon the name. Whosoever. Black, white, male, female, young, old, born in this country. Whosoever call upon the name shall be saved. There are no other name. Highly exalted. The man give him that name in three areas. By bestowal, by conquest, and by inheritance. Jesus. Jesus. And leave it out. We hear about everything else. Mm-hmm. Jesus is conspicuously absent. The name that's above every name. Jesus. Acts chapter 16. And let's pick it up at the 16th verse and see what God is saying to us. Acts chapter 16. And let's pick it up at the 16th verse. And it came to pass that the one to pray a certain damsel possessed with the spirit of divination met us, which brought the masters much gain by soothsaying. The same followed Paul and us and cried, saying, these men are servants of the Most High God, which shows the way of salvation. This she did many days, Paul being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out the same hour, in the name of Jesus. He didn't say in the name of Paul. In the name of Jesus. He wouldn't come out. If he said in the name of Paul, he wouldn't come out. In the name of Jesus. Every knee have to bow, beings in heaven, on earth, and under the earth have to bow to that name. He didn't say in Paul's name. No, in the name of Jesus. I command you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. No, Jesus, he's not coming out. That man who was a cripple from his mother's womb, said, silver and gold have I none, such as I, in the name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We talk about everything else, but leave him out of it. Leave Jesus out of it. Well, he's the chief cornerstone. You leave him out, the house is going to come crumbling. How about God? No, the name. The name. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Yeah, they're stopping the tracks. Jesus. Jesus. Evil spirit had them all wrapped up that they're going to take their life. Young men in the mid-30s or so to take their life. Yeah, stop them in the track. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Yeah, stop them in the track. Yeah, look at this here in the 18th verse. This she did many days, Paul being grieved and turned and said to the spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out the same hour. Can you see that? Name of Jesus. That's the only name going to make you move. Jesus. In that realm, in that other realm, in this realm and the realm under the earth, you're going to bow to that name. Jesus defeat principalities and power, making us show them openly. Defeat them. Inherit this name above every name, a more excellent name than all of them. And we take a little time and chew on this name. How important is it? Jesus, 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 Jesus. There's a lot of people seeing Jesus. We will know in the next segment and see who have the right to use the name. Is there anybody could know? Everybody does have a right to use the name Jesus. We're going to get to that when we get to that with scriptures. Amen. Acts chapter 19. Acts chapter 19. The name. The name. How important is the name? We leave it out. We leave the name of Jesus out. Put everything else in, but leave Jesus out. Mm-hmm. And very, very frightening. You go places, nobody's there, people praying. Here the man at the inauguration praying, he closed up the prayer, didn't he mention Jesus? Didn't he mention Jesus? Didn't he mention Jesus? Say amen. Amen, that's for the old covenant. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. Whatsoever he has the Father in my name, he's going to give it to you. Whatsoever he has the Father in my name, he'll give it to you. Mm-hmm. Together, in my name, I'll be there. My name. In my name, man crippled, in the name of Jesus, stand up and walk. Not in the name of Peter, in the name of Jesus. Command you in the name of Jesus, come out. Not in the name of Paul, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Highly exalt him and give him a name that's above every name. That name, every knee have to bow to that name. And if we can close in on that, staying on that, get the scripture and staying on it. Jesus, 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 before you go to bed tonight, Jesus, 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 Jesus. First thing, get up in the morning, Jesus, Jesus, amen. Jesus, Jesus. Amen. Open your window and just Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Let those words get out there with your name on it. Throughout your house, walk through your house. Jesus, Jesus. Have these words all over. Lay hands on your kids and your husband, your wife before they go to bed. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 19. Look at verse 1. And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul, having passed through the upper coast, came to Ephesus, finding certain disciples. And he said unto them, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? And they said unto him, we have not so much heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. And he said unto them, what were you baptized? And they said unto him, unto John's baptism. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto people, I should believe on him that should come and that is on Christ. When they heard this, they were baptized in. They were baptized in. They were baptized in. Huh? They were baptized in the name of Jesus. Look at that. I hear that they were baptized in the name of Jesus. When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, our Lord Jesus. When Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Ghost came on them, and they spake with tongues and prophesied. All the men were about 12. In the name of Jesus. They were baptized in the name of Jesus. They were baptized in the name of Jesus. You see? If they don't use that name Jesus there, John baptism of repentance is the new covenant baptism in the name of Jesus. Go baptize in the name of the Father, the Son, and the baptize in the name. In the name. In the name. Can you see that? Wonderful that we leave that name out. Look at the Apostle Paul who wrote most of the New Testament. This always blessed me. This is where you get your cue from, not from the supposedly prophet or bishop or whoever he or she think there. Get it from the Bible. Have your Bible. When you go to Africa, you go to the Caribbean, you go to Europe or Asia, anywhere you go, you have the Bible with you. What was conspicuously absent down in Jonestown, Guyana, was no Bible. Couldn't find any Bible on the premises. She starved the people of spiritual thing. Whatever he said, that's it. No. You have the Bible. You have to verify what he's saying with the word. Your faith should not supposed to be in any pastor, any bishop or apostle. Your faith have to be in Jesus Christ. Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. I put it differently. I don't think doing any injustice. Follow Christ as I follow Christ. Follow no man. He could be messed up and because he messed up, you're going to know. You follow Jesus Christ.
That's right.
My job is to point you to him, share the Bible. If there's too much Bible for me, well, you better get it. Or you arrive on the other side, you go, you wish you had Bible. You wish you had Bible. Look at the Apostle Paul who wrote most of the, look at him. He wrote most of the New Covenant. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus, 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 Jesus. And he wrote most of the New Covenant. He most wrote the New Covenant. He said, everything I got to get from Revelation of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
you go to some place, he have it there. Jesus, Jesus, mm-hmm. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Yes.
God told me this, and the Lord said this, and the Lord speak a word in your heart, and the Lord, do they know Jesus? Look at this. Look at the Apostle Paul. I get it from him. He said, everything he received, what he received, he delivered unto us. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, the Apostle Paul. 46 minutes after the first hour. Look at the Apostle Paul. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus. Take your cue from there, not from the bishop or the apostle, but some creation of God, think they know something. Take it from there. Jesus, everything, two of three gather in my name. There's no other name under heaven to be saved. The devil come out in his name, they're baptized in his name. Stand up and walk in the name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Look how many times the Apostle Paul mentioned the word Jesus. And take from him, and if you look at all the epistles, it seemed like he just addicted to the word Jesus all the time. But look how much revelation he had. Most of the New Covenant came from the Apostle Paul, from Romans to the book of Hebrews. And they couldn't tell me, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. But you talk about everything else, but men, leave Jesus out. Don't quote no scripture, don't mention anything. Just, you know, just leave it out there. And somehow it's going to work. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. Look at 1 Corinthians. Look how many times, get something to write, get something to write. Look how many times he mentioned in one chapter, Jesus Christ. Watch this. And we're not going to read the whole chapter, just part of it. You're not going to read the whole chapter as part of it, but if you read all of it, you see how many times he mentioned Jesus. Look at this. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, and let's pick it up at verse 1. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus, the Apostle Paul, who said he saw Jesus in the Damascus Road. He speaks in tongues more than you all. He was caught up in the third heaven, Jesus Christ. He said that about this. Look at this. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 1. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus Christ in this one chapter. We're not going to read the whole chapter. If you read the whole chapter, we'll see how many times. You should do that for your homework. Just get that first chapter and see how many times. Every time you see Jesus or Jesus Christ or Jesus Lord, then that mark it or see how many times in one chapter. Look at these few verses. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus Christ. Watch this. Look at this. Paul, called to be an apostle of Jesus Christ to the will of God and sustain our brother. Unto the church of God which is in Corinth, and to them that are sanctified in Jesus Christ and called to be saints. All that be in every place call upon the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, both theirs and ours. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. How many times you got so far?
Four.
I thank my God always upon your behalf for the grace of our God which is given by Jesus Christ. That in everything that you are enriched by him in all utterance and all knowledge, even the testimony of Christ was confirmed in you, so that you come behind in no gift waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Who shall also confirm unto the end that you may be blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful by who you call unto the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. I beseech you, brethren, by the name of... Look at how many times we have so far. How many fingers are you showing me there?
10.
How many you have out there in radio land? Look how many times he mentioned... And we didn't... This is only 10 verses. And this chapter go down to the 31st verse. So you on your homework, you mark down how many times Paul went in one chapter, how many times he mentioned Jesus Christ, Jesus Lord, Jesus, but how many times he mentioned. You, that's your homework. Mark it down. How many times he mentioned. But you go to some church and never mention Jesus, talk about God, this and God, the other and God, the other. No, it's Jesus. He gave us a name, that name. Paul didn't say God, he said, in the name of Jesus, come out. In the name of Jesus, stand up and walk. If you got to get in my name, whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it to you. Look how many times he mentioned. That's your homework. You mark that down. That's your homework. How many times he mentioned the word Jesus Christ in it? We just look at that. We had about 10 times or so. Yeah. Look at that. My wife is counting. How many times he mentioned Jesus Christ? That's your homework. You mark that down. How many in one chapter? And you look at all the letters of all the Romans, believers, those at Corinth, those in Thessalonica, those in Colossae, those in Galatia. Look at
17.
Look how many times he mentioned your name.
17.
Jesus. Yeah. How many times he mentioned? I think it's more than that, but all right, we leave it at 17. Yeah. Name that's above every name. That name that might highly exalt him and give him a name. Every time we all just read up to the 10th verse. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Hard pressed here to talk anything about Jesus Christ. Yeah. A name that's above every name. No other name for you to get saved. And I could look back at my time in church, going places, never hear the name Jesus. My children give them paper and pencil to write with. Anytime you hear them mention Jesus, mark it down. Something, never mention the name Jesus. Never. Conspicuously absent, never mention the name Jesus. Hallelujah. Look at something before we go to the next segment. Look at this here. Look at this in Luke chapter 2, before we get to part 2. Look at Luke chapter 2, and look at something. Look at this. The Bible says, that which was is that which is, that which shall be done is that which is done, is nothing new under the sun. Same devil, same religious spirit in most of these churches. Have them using all the words. Don't use the name of his power. Jesus, Satan have to run by that from that name. Jesus. Can't get saved in no other name. Crippled man is not going to, you know, in the name of Jesus. To raise the dead, in the name of Jesus. You need that name. That name. That's above every name. We have a product that we don't advertise our product. And you listen to many of these supposedly Christian radio station and television station. They're not advertising our product. We have a better product than the devil and his crowd, but nobody's advertising our product that raised the dead, cast out devils, open blind eyes, unstop deaf ears, make the cripple walk, and do all Lazarus being 4 days dead. Our product, we're not advertising our product. You're not hearing more about our product. Make the Red Sea open, that make manna fall from heaven, that make water come out of the rock, make bitter water sweet. Never talk about these things. Never talk about our product. Get the sun and the moon to stand still. Sun stand still in Gibeon. Moon in the Valley of Ajalon, stand still. Get the sun dial to go back 10 degrees. All if we never talk about our product. We advertise everything else. The devil in his cross spend billions of dollars advertising their product, but we have a better product than theirs, and we're not advertising our product. It's a rarity to hear them talk about Jesus Christ. God this and God said that. No, what about Jesus? Jesus. God. Remember, Satan is the God of this world. And we sometimes say, God, we don't know which God you're talking about. And you see that. Look at the book here, Luke chapter 2. And look at something. It's that with same old thing. Same old. Nothing had changed. Look at this. Luke chapter 2, verse 1. And it came to pass in those days that they went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went out to be taxed, every one unto his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth unto Judea, unto the city of David, which was called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. Look at verse 7. Look at the 7th verse. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because, put him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. They didn't say there was no room at the inn. There was no room for them at the inn. Look at that 7th verse. They brought forth a firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them. Yeah, if Herod come, they'll find room for Herod. If Pontius Pilate come, they'll find room for Pontius Pilate. Yeah, they'll find for Felix the governor. But there was no room for them. Same thing in church. That same religious spirit, 1,000 years still in churches today. Yeah, no room for Jesus. Yeah, no room for Jesus. They didn't say there was no room at the inn. There was no room for them at the inn. And many churches ago, there's no room for them. No room for Jesus. Talk about everything else. All the women's there and the men there and the bus ride and the street fair, everything else, but Jesus is conspicuously absent. No room for Jesus. No room for Jesus. Listen to this man preaching a sermon here. It's 4 points. Point number one, point number two, point number three, and we're going to conclude at point number four. No Jesus. Yeah, the 4 points, you end up in hell with 4 points. No Jesus. Yeah, conspicuously absent. Didn't say there was no room at the inn, there was no room for them. That which was is that which is, that which shall be done is that which is done. Name. This very important name, that salvation, number one, that determined whether we're going to heaven or hell. That name determined that. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believe and is baptized shall be saved. He that believe not shall be damned. So that name, believe in the name. Whosoever call upon the name shall be saved. You didn't call upon the name, you're not saved. Can you fill out a card and get saved by that? The shake pastor's hand or the bishop and get saved? No, whosoever call upon the name, confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord. And you listening to this, you seniors that are listening, I hope you're listening. If you feel like you're getting ready to leave, to make your exit here, your sunset time is coming, or so what they say, call out on Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh God, I ain't going to help you. Jesus. Jesus. I'm sorry. You're right. I'm wrong. Call out on Jesus. Get in the accident. It doesn't look good. You're going to the hospital. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Make sure to mention that name. Put that down on the record quick. Jesus, 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 the name that's above every name. The name that's above every name. Can you see that? He said there was no room for them at the inn. They said there was no room, there was no room for them at the inn. Can you see that? Amen, amen, and amen. 56 minutes after the first hour. And see what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious, wordy name. Very, very important. Get that down, get it, and have it. You don't have it, you're going to be at a disadvantage. You don't have that name. Get the name and hear what God has to say to us in his holy, written, precious words. The name. Acts chapter 2, part 2. And hear what God has to say to us. The name. Look at the day of Pentecost. Church just getting started off the ground. And we need some time to go back. The church in the early years was called the Way. But what happened over the years, the church lost its way and get involved in church, get involved in religion and denomination, customs and tradition. The church lost its way. Sad. Everything else but Jesus. Went to a church, my wife and I went into the church, sing 35 songs. I mean, how many songs are you going to sing? Went to another church to take up 7 offerings. How much offerings you going to take out? Put everything in one envelope for the building fund, for the pastor's salary, for the tithes. Put one everything and just do one. No, 7 different people have to come up and say 7 different things for 7 different offerings. Wasting over 2.5 hours. 35, so how many songs are you going to sing? Where's the word? Where's the word? Sad. You're in the wrong church. You could end up on the other side and asking yourself, what am I doing here? I'm a good person. I was in the choir. I was on the board. I drive the bus. I cook the food. I was in the nursery. You could do all that and end up straight in hell. Me and the pastor was very close. I was his armor bearer, whatever that is. And you could do all that and end up straight in hell. That day, many are going to say to me, Lord, Lord, have we not? Don't want to read your Bible. Take time to study. Study to show yourself approved. Paul said to Timothy, from a child you know the Holy Scripture. But yet he said to Timothy, study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of God. You're going to be ashamed. Acts chapter 2, look at the day of Pentecost. And look at this, look at this. The new church just getting together and ministering to these new believers. And look at this. Keep look at this all the time. Keep these words before you all the time. Look at it. Acts chapter 2, pick it up at verse 1. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they had all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind and filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues as a fire and sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And they were dwelling in Jerusalem, Jews, and they were men from every nation under the heaven. When they heard the noise abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, are not all these speak Galilean? How we every man in his own tongue when we were born, Parthians and Medes, Elamites, dwellers in Mesopotamia and in Judea and Cappadocia, in Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, in Egypt, parts of Libya, about Cyrene, strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabian, we do hear them speak in our own tongue the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed and in doubt, some saying one to another, what mean is this? Others saying that these men are full of new wine. But Peter, standing up with 11, lift up his voice and said unto them, you men of Judea and all you that dwell in Jerusalem, be it known unto you, and be hearken unto my words. These are not drunkenness, you suppose, since but the third hour of the day. This is that which was spoken of the prophet Joel, that it shall come to pass in the last days that God will pour the Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your young men shall see vision, your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servant and on my handmaid I'll pour out my Spirit in those days of my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I'll show wonders in the heavens above, and signs in the earth beneath, and blood, and fire, and vapor, and smoke. Sun shall be darkened and turn into the blood, and darkness and the moon turn into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord. Come, look at verse 21. All those people from all over the world in Mesopotamia, and Cappadocia, and Cyrene, and all over the world come there. Look at what all these people have to do. Look at verse 21. Look at verse 21. It shall come to pass, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So all those people, you look at it from all the different places they came from. Look at all where they came from. All of them have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. All these people that come from, and he said, whosoever. He said, in the last, he poured the Spirit upon all flesh. In verse 20, the sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before that great and terrible, notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass, whosoever. So whosoever is those folks, when you go back up to, when you go back up to verse 9, Parthians and Medes, Elamite, dwellers of Mesopotamia and in Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, in Egypt, parts of Libya about Cyrene, strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabian. We do hear them speak the wonderful. All these folks have to call upon the name of the Lord. So whatever part of the world you come from, Jesus is Lord. That's number one, because nothing else could work. If you don't have this, you don't have that. You don't have eternal life. You have eternal debt. So all those folks from all of you way back then have to call upon the name of Jesus Christ. When you go down to the 37th verse, go down to that same, look at the 37th verse. Look at the 37th verse of that same chapter. Look at the 37th verse. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name. In the name. So these multitudes of people, thousands of people at Jerusalem on the day of Pentecost, Peter's all of them in the name. Look at verse 38. Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, everyone, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remissions of sin, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you and unto your children and to all that are far, even as many as the Lord God shall call. And with many other words they did testify and exhort, saying, save yourself from this untoward generation. Look at verse 41. Put your finger on verse 41. Look at verse 41. Look how many people. Look how many people have to confess that. Look how many people. I mean, this is something. I don't know if you're getting, while I'm cooking, I'm eating. While I'm cooking, I'm eating. Look at that 41st verse. All those from Pamphylia, from Egypt, from all over, from Arabia, from Cyrene, parts of Libya, all those folks, thousands of people. Look how many people got saved that day. I have to read that again. I like this. I got to read that again. I got to read that again. I go back and read 37th verse. I'm going to read this again. While I'm cooking, I'm eating. Look at the 37th verse. And when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you and unto your children, and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord God shall call. And with many other words he did testify and exhort, saying, save yourself from this untoward generation. Look at verse 41. Then they that gladly received the word were baptized, and the same day they were added unto them 3,000. Mercy. 3,000 people, one shot. 3,000, all those people from Pamphylia and from Egypt, all those folks was at Jerusalem on the day of Pentecost. All of them, whosoever call upon the name, what shall we do? Call upon the name of Jesus. Call upon the name of Jesus. No, they didn't call on Peter and Paul and James and John, Andrew, Matthew. Jesus. Call upon them. 3,000 people. Isn't that something? 3,000, all of them have to be at one accord. All of them have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Whosoever shall call upon the name, black, white, whether you're from Egypt, you're from Libya, you're from Phrygia, Pamphylia, from Rome, wherever you come from, that's the revelation where they come from all about, but all of them still have to confess that Jesus is Lord. Not because you come from Egypt, you have to confess something else. You know, people have all these strains and religion from the East and talking all sort of foolishness. These folks are from all over the world, and all of them have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You have a special God for Egypt, and a next one for Libya, and a next one for Arabia, and a next one for Pamphylia, and a next one for Cyrene. All of them come to the, all of them have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So
hallelujah.
When you come from Tobago, you come from Grenada and St. Vincent and Barbados,
yes,
and Jamaica and Haiti and the Dominican Republic and Cuba and Puerto Rico and the Bahamas. Wherever you come from, all of you have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You come from all over Egypt, whatever country you come in Egypt, whether from the northern part of Egypt, the southern part of Egypt, the eastern part or the western part of Africa, sorry, you have to confess that Jesus is Lord. So it's not a special God for those up in North, Libya, Chad, Sudan, Tunisia, and Algeria, and all those up in North, a special God. No, all of them have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. If you come from the east of Africa, Somalia, and Ethiopia, and Kenya, and all those countries from the east, you have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. South Africa, and Angola, Mozambique, and Zimbabwe, and all those down in the south, they all of them have to confess. In the west, Nigeria, and Liberia, and Ghana, and Burkina Faso, and Sierra Leone, all those in the west part of Africa, all of you folks have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. So I don't care what part of the west, whether you're Greater or Lesser Antilles or the Bahamas Island, you have to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. That's the revelation. All of them come to eat from all over the world.
Yes.
Come there to the, I got to read that again. I got to read that again while I'm cooking. We're going back up to verse 1 again. Get something to write with and something to write on. This is Choice Radio 92.9. FM, your life, your salvation, your choice. This is the Christian family over the church, 347-533-4271. Here the studio, 347-663-8638. Yes, I got to read that again. I like that because all over there, all of them have to confess. So these crazy folks come from all over the world think that they have to come with this strange God and they don't believe in this. And no, everybody did. Jews and proselytes, everybody have to confess that Jesus Christ. So let me go read that again. I like that. I mean, this is good for me. I don't know about you. This is good for me. This is good for me. Look at that one more time. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they had one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a song from heaven, as a rushing mighty wind, and filled the house where they were sitting. And they appeared unto them, cloven as a fire sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. And they were dwelling at Jerusalem, Jews and devout men from every nation under the heaven. Let me see you get out of that. Every nation under the heaven. Every nation under the heaven. So all those nations have to confess. What shall we do? Jesus Christ is Lord. Call upon the name. So the name is good in Africa. It's good in Asia. It's good in Europe. Good in the Americas. All the Caribbean. North America, Central America, South America. That name is good everywhere. But can you read? And they were dwelling in Jerusalem. Jews are devout men from every nation under the heaven. Now when there was noise abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one towards another, behold, are not all these speak Galilean? How hear we every man in our own tongue when we were born? Partitions and Medes and Elamite, dwellers of Mesopotamia, and in Judea and Cappadocia, in Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, in Egypt, and parts of Libya about Cyrene, and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabian, we do hear them speak in our tongue the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed and were in doubt, saying one to another, what means this? Others mocking and saying, these men are full of new wine. Peter, standing up with the 11, lift up his voice and said unto them, you men of Judea and all you that dwell in Jerusalem, be it known unto you and hearken unto my words. For these are not drunkenness, you suppose, seen, but the third hour of the day. This is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it had come to pass in the last days, said God, I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see vision, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servant and on my handmaiden, I'll pour my spirit, and those that my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I'll show wonders in the heaven above, and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor and smoke. And the sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before that great and notable day of the Lord come. Look at verse 21. Put your finger on verse 21. Look at verse 21. And it shall come to pass, whosoever, whosoever, black, white, male, female, born in this country, whosoever, all over the world, whosoever, every country all over the world was in Jerusalem at that time. Look at that. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Go on to 37 verse. Go on to 37 verse. Look at 37 verse. And when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized. You see, people who are not saved have to repent. People who are not saved have to repent. You see that? Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of, in the name, in the name, in the name, in the name, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remissions of sin. Get wipe away all your sins. You see, in the old covenant, they cover your sins. In the new covenant, they get rid of your sins. In the old covenant, you take your sins to the high priest, and you take it into the holies of holies, and they cover it for 1 year. Don't get to cover it. In the new covenant, they get rid of it for the remission of sin. Wipe it out. Jesus was delivered for your offenses and raised again for your justification. All your sins that you committed, all the murder and rape and lie and abortion, all the wrong things you do, Jesus died for all of that. When you receive him as Lord and Savior, that bill is paid. He was delivered for your offenses and raised again for your justification. When he rose from the dead, everything that you had done wrong, you confess him, is paid for. You have a clean slate. Satan could not come back and throw no drug dealing in your face, no prostitution in your face, no lesbian behavior in your face, no murder in your face. Nah, the bill is paid, not me. Go to Jesus, he has it. He paid the bill, I don't got it. He was delivered for your offenses and he raised again for your justification. So you don't got nothing. Whosoever call, look at it. Look at the promises unto you. Look at the good verse 38. And Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, for the remissions of your sins. All your sins are gone. All your sins are gone. Anytime that sin come back to you, that's not God, that's the devil. He said, I'll not remember it anymore. So anytime it come back, that abortion or that rape or that murder or that whatever, it come back, that's not God, it's the devil. But once you come to Jesus Christ, he said, I'll not remember it anymore. Put it in the sea of forgiveness, cast it away. So it's not, anytime that thought come back, rebuke it in the name of Jesus. That's not God, that's the devil. That's not God, that's the devil. He said, once you come to him, he wiped his slate clean. He was delivered for your offenses. He raised again for your justification. You have no sin. You're clean. I'm a new creature. Anybody come to try and put that? I'm a new creature. Did you come with that boy? I'm a new creature. Were you unfaithful to your husband or your wife? I'm a new creature. I didn't do it. I'm a new creature. You see, Paul went before King Agrippa and he said, slap him in his mouth. You see, the old Paul did all about it. He said, I hurt nobody. I did nobody wrong. But King Agrippa said, slap him in his mouth. You see, that's the old Paul did that, but the new Paul didn't do anything. I didn't do that. I didn't hurt nobody, take nobody apart or anything like that. That's the old Paul did that. You see, the new Paul come and bring back that things from the past that you did when you were working for the devil. That, no, you were delivered from darkness into light. I'm not in that kingdom anymore. I'm not responsible. Not me. Go to Jesus. He has it. He has it. So he said, call upon the name of the Lord. Repent and be, look at the 38. Peter said all of them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sin. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, for the promise is unto you and unto your children and to all that are far, even as many as the Lord God shall call. And with many other words, he did testify and exhort them, saying, save yourself from this untoward generation. Look at verse 41. All those folks from Egypt and Libya and Chad, all over the place, every all those folks, look at verse 41. Then they that gladly received the word were baptized, and the same day they were added unto them 3,000 souls. Mercy. Glory to God. Ephesians chapter 5, the name. The name. Ephesians chapter 5. Is Ephesians in the Bible?
Yes, it is.
Just want to make sure we're in the B-I-B.
L-E.
Ephesians chapter 5. The name. The name. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. That name is conspicuously absent. Jesus. If you feel like your life leaving your body, start calling out the name. Jesus. 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 Don't say, oh God, that ain't going to help you. Jesus. Jesus, I'm sorry, you right, I'm wrong. Forgive me. Hallelujah. Call the name Jesus. Ephesians chapter 5, look at two verses. Look at 19 and 20, the name. Speaking to yourselves in psalm and hymn and spiritual songs, singing, making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name. Giving thanks to God and Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The name Lord Jesus Christ. The name Lord Jesus Christ. That name come all the way from the third heaven. Angels bring it all here, give it to Mary. When he was hand up for his circumcision, they give him that name Jesus. That name above every name, that at that name every knee have to bow. Beings in heaven and earth and under the earth have to bow to that name. He got that name in three areas. By bestowal, by conquest, and by inheritance. Jesus. We're not advertising our product.
Amen.
We have a better product than them. We're not advertising
yes.
our product.
Yes. Amen.
We're not advertising our product. We have a better product than they. They spend billions of dollars advertising pornography and guns and blood and all kind of junk. Junk. And we're not advertising our product. You go throughout the city, you cannot see a billboard nowhere with something for Jesus. All sort of half-naked people, cigarettes and beers and all kind of junk and those billboards. You're traveling train, all through the train, on the bus. Not a single thing about Jesus Christ. We went down to Trinidad, we're looking to put some, we travel all the way down to the south. We went down into the west part of Trinidad, we went down to the west. And looking at all those billboards, we see nothing about Jesus. Nothing but Jesus. We saw one thing and going up towards the east, a church advertising a service. Mm-hmm. But now anything about Jesus. Advertising a service, telling them, you know, they give the address of the church and the pastor and so on. That's the only thing I see. But Jesus, all throughout, you see cell phone and bear and everything else, but no Jesus. No Jesus. Conspicuously absent, we have to advertise Jesus. Hallelujah. So look at those two verses, speaking to yourselves in psalm and hymn and spiritual song, singing, making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always, for all things unto God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, in the name, in the name, in the name, in the name. Look at the book of Colossians. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 3. And let's see what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious word. The name. The name. The name. Colossians chapter 3. I would like to give you verses, but I'm going to give you a verse. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 3. Look at the 17th verse. Look at the 17th verse. Colossians chapter 3. Look at verse 17. Look at verse 17. Colossians chapter 3. Look at verse 17. Whatsoever you do in words or deed, do all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. We have to read that again. Whatsoever you do in words and deed. Whatever you're doing in words and deed. Look at that. 17th verse. Colossians chapter 3 verse 17. Look at that. The name. The name. The name. 17th verse. And whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. You notice God is our God and he's our Father. He's two things. To the world, he's God. But to us, he's God and Father. To them, he's God. But to us, he's God and Father. Whatsoever you do in the word or deed, do all in the name. Do all in the name. Do all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father by him. James chapter 5. The name. James chapter 5. James chapter 5. And see what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious word. James chapter 5. Glory to God. James chapter 5. Let's pick it up at the 14th verse. In the name. In the name. Hallelujah. In the name. In the name. Jesus. 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 I was baptized in water. I'm a member of the church. I read Granny Bible. That ain't cutting it. When he mentioned Jesus, somewhere out of his inner being come out the word Jesus. Pull him back into his body. Two young men going to take their life. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Greater is he who is in me than he is in the world. Quoting all his scripture. That didn't stop them. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. They stop in the trap. Jesus is Lord. We have a better product than them. We need to advertise our product. Hallelujah. James chapter 5, look at verse 14. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. Let them pray over him. Anointed him with oil in the name, in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. If he have committed sin, it shall be forgiven him. Confess your faults one to another, pray one for another, that you may be healed. The effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. You only go to verse 7 and say, Elias was a man of like passion just as we are. But that's not what we're looking at, that's something else. I mean, here's this guy. They say he's like passion, we are. And here Elisha raised the widow's son back to life, and he's a man of like passion. Elisha prayed that it wouldn't rain 3 years and 6 months, and it didn't rain. And he prayed again at the rain, but yet he's a man of like passion as we are. Elisha, make fire come from heaven and consume the messenger of the king. Elisha did that. Elisha went up against 450 prophets of Baal and defeated them. Elisha did that, but he's a man of like passion as we are. So we could do that too. Yeah, he wasn't even saved. He was a servant. We are son. He under the old covenant. We under the new covenant. We have a better covenant established upon better promises. And he's a man of like passion as we are. How do you like that? Take his mantle, hit the Jordan River, and it passed hither and thither. And it went across on dry land. Elijah, a man of like passion as we are. Fire come over heaven and consume the messenger of the king. And see that he did all that. But he's a man of like passion as we are. How do you like that? Elisha. But look at that 14th verse. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. Let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. So if the name is not used, it's not good. The anointing is not going to do any good if you don't use the name. Now, if you don't call upon the name, if you don't end your prayer in Jesus' name, it's not going anywhere. Whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it to you. If you didn't put his name, he's not going to do. Well, two or three, I got to get it. In my name, I'm there. If he's not, his name is not, he's not there. Come out in the name of Jesus. The devil is not going to move until he mentions the name Jesus, not the name Paul or Peter or John. Jesus. There's no other name under heaven where a man will be saved. No other name. God has highly exalted him and given him a name that's above every name. That by that name, every knee must bow to that name. Every knee in Asia, in Africa, in Europe, throughout the world, every knee have to bow to that name. You don't bow now, you're going to bow in the process of time. You're going to bow. When you go before the great white throne, you're going to bow. You don't bow now, you're going to bow over there. Yeah, the rich man allows you go over there. Yeah, Father Abraham. Yeah, Father Abraham. I know. I know. Oh, now it's time for Father Abraham. When the rich die on the other side, crying out for Father Abraham. It's too late. Too late. If you wait until you need faith to get faith, it's too late. It's too late. Anoint him in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Can you see that? Hallelujah. 22 minutes after the second hour. Look at the book of Luke. Let's go. We look at this just now. And let's just pick up this again. Luke chapter 2. Let's go back there. We just read it, but we want to read it again and put it in the next context. Luke chapter 2. I wanted to the pastor say not. No, the Bible say. I didn't say nothing. The Bible say. You're not supposed to put your confidence in me or anybody else. Put your faith in me. Put it in the word of God. That's what make it work. The name Jesus. Paul didn't say trust in me or trust in Peter or Paul. No, in the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 2. And we look into this, we look at it, we put it in the next context now. Luke chapter 2, verse 1. It came to pass in those days they went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And they all went out to be taxed, everyone at his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out to the city of Nazareth, on to Judea, on to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his ex-wife, by being great with child. I was so that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. Brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them at the inn. There's no room for Jesus. And that continued even today. As we speak, there's still no room for Jesus. And you could say amen to that. I was part of a church, a Pentecostal church, and this is the sad thing about it. I mean, I think I would have had it made in the shade. And I could have died and goes to hell. And I could never remember, not a single time in 5.5 years I spent with them working over there. Not a single time remember that we went through the salvation prayer, what it means to be saved, or went through the name of Jesus, how important is the name, prayer, how to pray and how to do it, and these things. Never the senior pastor put us together and sit down and we discuss scripture and talk about, you know, baptism of the Holy. Never. They listen to me on radio, they're out there, some of them still listen to me. They don't know when I'm coming on, they listen, they know. But they could say amen to that. Never open the Bible like I open up the Bible and read this thing and fall around. We don't know it all. You don't know it all either. The Apostle Paul wrote most of the New Covenant. He said, we know in part. We prophesy in part. We see through glass. So you don't know it all either. But we're highlighting a few things here and there. And we hope when we come to a conclusion of this study, somehow we're able to stimulate thought and excitement of faculties, get to do some serious thinking in the Word of God. That is more to the Word of God in the Lord's Prayer, the 23rd Psalm. All is in the name. The name. There's no room for them at the inn. They say there's no room at the inn, no room for them at the inn. Look at Mark, M-A-R-K is Mark. And see what God is saying to us. Hallelujah. Mark. And look at this. When you read some of these things, I mean, it just, if you would, with your inner ear, you have eyes to see and have ears to hear, have heart to pick things up. And look at the audacity of these evil spirits, of these people. Look at this reading. Mark, M-A-R-K is Mark, chapter 1. And look at this here. Mark chapter 1, pick up at the 21st verse. Mark chapter 1, look at verse 21. And when they went into Capernaum, straightway on the Sabbath day, they entered into the synagogue and taught. The synagogue is the church, is that true? The synagogue is the church. Watch this. And taught. And they were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one that had authority and not as the scribe. And there was in their synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out. A man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out. Look what the man's saying. He cried out, saying, let us alone. What have we to do with thee? Jesus of Nazareth, art thou come to destroy us? I know thee, who thou art, the Holy One. Now he's in the church. Really, leave us alone. Leave us alone. Don't come into our church. Go from here. Leave us alone. This is a church. This is not about you. This is not about you. Jesus, head of the church. Jesus, the head of the church. Jesus, the head of the church. Look at this. Evil spirit saying, there was a synagogue, a man with the horn, please. He cried out, saying, let us alone. Leave us alone. Come on, teaching this Jesus business here. Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. Name of Jesus. No. We don't want to hear that. What goes up must come down. What goes around must come around. Two and two or four will then four and four must be eight. That talk about that. Talk about the fish fry. Talk about the bus ride and the boat ride. Yeah, talk about the baptism classes. Talk about all these things. Yeah, talk about the party. We're talking about Jesus now, not Jesus here, the name of Jesus. We don't want to hear that. Look at it. Let us alone. What have we to do with thee, Jesus of Nazareth? Thou come to destroy us? I know the Hurawa, the Holy One of God. Now that's an insult. The evil spirit know that he's the Holy One of God. And you know that Christian means saved for years don't know that Jesus is Lord. You know that Christian who's saved for years don't know Jesus is Lord. Look at the evil spirit said, I know the Hurawa, the Holy One. Jesus, look at that 24th verse. Let us alone. What have we to do with thee, Jesus of Nazareth? I know the Hurawa, the Holy One of God. Evil spirit know that he's the Holy One of God. And they are Christian full of something, don't know that Jesus is the Holy One of God. Don't know Jesus of Nazareth. People still today were asking if Jesus is Lord. Today, even today, 2,000 years later, still ask me, who do men say that I am? Well, some say Jeremiah or Elijah or one of the prophets. Or who do you say that I am? Well, Peter said, you're the Christ. He said, I didn't tell you that. The Spirit of God revealed that to you. Can you see that? Yeah, leave us alone. What have I to do with it? Look at verse 25. Jesus rebuked him and saying, hold thy peace and come out of him. And when the unclean spirit had torn him, he cried with a loud voice and came out of him. And they all were amazed in so much that they questioned among themselves, saying, what thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority he command even the unclean spirit, and they do obey him. With authority he command the unclean spirit. Look at the unclean spirit. Leave us alone. Leave us alone. Some churches you go, you cannot speak in tongues. They don't want you speaking in tongues. They get out. They don't know Jesus says about the bishop and the apostle and the prophet. Everybody have a title. Bishop this and apostle this and deacon is that and pastor this. Everybody have a title. Doctor this. Nobody, what happened to have the brother and sister? What happened to brother and sister? Yeah, brother this and sister. No, we have a title. Deacon and deaconess and prophet and prophetess this and apostle. Everybody have a title. Nobody have a name, no more have a title. Deacon this and the other apostle this, doctor this. Yeah. Hallelujah. Everybody have something. So he said, leave us alone. Leave us alone. Don't mess with us. Just leave us alone. Look at Acts chapter 4. Acts chapter 4. And see what God is saying to us in his holy. No Jesus. No Jesus. We don't want no Jesus. Leave us alone. There's no room for him at the end. And throughout, as you listen, think about rewind the tape back. I could remind you about all those churches that I've been to and listen to what they're teaching. A lot of preaching, a lot of fancy stuff, you know, can't fly, you know, weight, load limit, you know, satanic verses. Nobody quit alone, that kind of stuff. I know Jesus. Jesus conspicuously appeared. And you think about it. Think about your church where you go to. Stop. Look at it here. Acts chapter 4. And look at this. Look at this. This is a new covenant. This is not the old. This is a new covenant. This is a new covenant. Acts chapter 4. Look at this. Verse 1. And as they speak unto the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them, being grieved that they taught the people and preached Jesus Christ the resurrection of the dead. And they laid their hands on them and put them on hold unto the next day. Grieved that they speak. Don't preach in that. Look at new covenant. Don't preach in Jesus Christ. Many, many places you go, know Jesus Christ. Even as we speak right now, look at this. And as they speak unto the people, and the priests, and the captain of the temple, the Sadducees came upon them, being grieved that they taught the people and preached Jesus Christ the resurrection from the dead. The Sadducees don't believe in the resurrection. They don't believe in angels, and they don't believe in spirit. Well, what kind of church is that? Don't believe in the resurrection. If there's no resurrection, then there's no salvation. If there's no salvation, all of us going to hell. Yeah, the resurrection is the most important day in the church, in the world. Everybody have to come to Jesus. If Jesus didn't resurrect from the dead, all of us going straight to hell. Besides, don't believe in the resurrection. They don't believe in angels and don't believe in spirit. Well, God is a spirit. If you don't believe in spirit, then God is a spirit. Huh? They don't believe in the resurrection. They don't believe in angels. They don't believe in spirits. God is a spirit. Jesus said, I am the resurrection. You see that? So they grieve that they taught. Look at it. And they speak unto the people, the priests and the captain of the temple. The Sadducees came upon them, being grieved that they taught the people and preached Jesus Christ the resurrection of the dead. And they laid their hands on them and put them on hold unto the next day for the evening time. Howbeit many of them which heard the word believe, and the number of men were about 5,000, and so on and so on. But they grieved that they taught the people in that name. Look at they go down to the 16th verse. at that same chapter, 16, but at that same chapter, the story continued. Put them on hold, put them in prison for teaching of Jesus. This is the new covenant. This is the new covenant. Most of these church women come up on Sunday morning, we see most of those church people going to church, no Bible.
None.
No Bible in their hands.
None.
No Bible. Say, look at this. But going to church, no Bible in their hand. And they come up and church, the pastor say. Yeah, but what does Jesus say? The pastor say. Yeah, what does the Bible say? Huh? Acts chapter 4, look at the 6th, go to the 16th verse. Pick up the same story. The 16th verse, look at it. Saying, what shall we do to these men? For they indeed a notable miracle that had been done by them, manifest to all them that dwell in Jerusalem, and cannot deny it. So the proof of the prison is needed. The man who was born a cripple, they lay hands on him, and this is the follow for this. Many people sat for him because this man was a cripple there at the gate, everybody seeing him there. Silver and gold have I none, such as I have, give I thee in the name. So this is advertisement for the church. So multitude of people coming. So this is a notable miracle. So now we have to stop this. Verse 17. But that it spread no further among the people, let us straightly threaten them that they speak henceforth no more. In what? In this name. Threaten them that they speak no more in the name. Look at the 17th verse. Look at it. But I spread no further among the people, let us straightly threaten them that they speak henceforth no more in the name. And they called them and commanded them not to speak at all or teach in the name of Jesus. Not just, this is the new covenant. This is today. Even as we speak.
Mm-hmm.
Even as we speak. And you just think about so many places you've been to. And if you hear anything about Jesus Christ. Religious spirit running those churches. Look at it. Command them. Ellen, look at verse 18. And they all called them and commanded them not to speak or to teach in the name of Jesus. And Peter and John answered and said unto them, whether it is right in the sight of God to hearken unto you or unto God, judge ye. For we cannot but speak those things which we have seen and heard. So when they had further threatened them, get up a dictionary and find what the word spell or what that word threaten mean. And look at it. So when they had further threatened them, let them go, finding nothing how they might punish them because of the people, for all men glorify God for what has done. For the man has been about 40 years who this miracle of healing was showed on. He said, threaten them. Don't speak in the name. Speak about anything else. Speak about Buddha, Hare Krishna, Muhammad. Speak about that, but don't speak in the name. Talk about the bus ride and the boat ride, fine, but don't speak about the name. Talk about the food, fine. Talk about the music, fine. Talk about the bishop and the apostle and the prophet, fine, but don't speak in the name. Don't speak in the name. Leave the name out, because you see, is the name going to bring healing? Is the name going to bring deliverance? Is the name going to bring salvation? Is the name going to bring all these things? Is the name, he tell Paul, saying, the name of Jesus Christ, come out. Is the name going to make the evil spirit come out? You see, stand up and walk in the name of Jesus. Whosoever call upon the name shall be saved. There's no other name under heaven to be saved. So it's the name. Don't speak about the name. Let them stay in darkness, so when they die, they go to hell. Working for Satan. Don't speak about that. Some churches, this church, we went to this mega church, and they tried to decontaminate. Don't speak in no tongues, say, get out. Yeah, he that speak in unknown tongues, speak it unto God. How be it in the spirit, he speak in mystery. How are you going to speak in tongues? The Apostle Paul says he speak in turmoil. What kind of church? You need to run from that church. The Apostle Paul, who wrote most of the New Covenant, he said, I speak in tongues more than you all. So what are you going to do with it? He's from the devil. Then Jesus Christ is the baptizer of the Holy Ghost. He's the one baptized, so he's of the devil too, of course. And people go to churches like that and put their money in there.
Mm-hmm.
Members of those kind of places. They call it, I don't know what they call them, mausoleum. Went to some cemetery in a mausoleum. Yeah, crazy. They got to command them. You see, the name is what's going to set the captive free. The name going to open the blind eye. The name going to unstop the deaf ear. The name going to make the cripple walk. The name going to move you from darkness to light. It's the name. You're baptized in the name.
Yes, yes.
The name.
Amen,
the name.
Yes.
From all over the world there, over 3,000 one shot. 5,000 again, the name. You see, it's a trick of the devil. Talk about God this and God said that, God spoke and work and God speak. God, and never, don't mention the name. Leave the name out. The name, we look at Paul just now, every minute in that one chapter.
Amen.
We wrote 10 verses. Jesus Christ, Jesus the Lord, everything, Lord Jesus, Jesus, Lord Jesus, all over, right, all through Jesus, Jesus, but no, don't mention the name, talk about God, you know, God did and God spoke to my heart and God do this and God said this and you know, keep the name out. You know, you see, that. Look at, they didn't tell me about God, look at, we're going to read it again, look at this, make sure they keep the name out, look at that, go back up to the 16th verse again, look at how, and then about God, the name, don't mention the name, don't mention Jesus' name, Don't mention Jesus' name. Mention anything else. Talk about any God. Satan is the God of this world. Talk about God. Holy Ghost, tell it is. And Holy Ghost. Yeah, look at this. Look at it. Saying, what shall we do to these men? For indeed this is a notable, verse 16, notable miracle that had been done by their manifesto to all them that dwell in Jerusalem. And we cannot deny it. The proof of the pudding is in eating. But as it spread no further among the people, let us straightly threaten them that they not speak henceforth no more in this name. See, speak in any other name, Hare Krishna and Buddha, any, speak in that name, fine, but not this name. This is the name will make the devil run. This is the name for salvation. This is the name for healing. Yes. This is the name for the, don't
Amen.
Speak in this name.
Hallelujah.
Talk about God, the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And you had a vision
yes.
last night. Talk about that kind of thing. Give a testimony about how things are hard and life is hard. And you know, talk about that. Yeah, look at it. Look at verse 17. But at the spread no further among the people, let us straightly train and not speak henceforth. And they call them together, command them not to speak or to teach in the name of Jesus.
My Lord.
Buddha is alright, Hare Krishna is alright, Muhammad is alright, Confucius is alright, education is alright, money is alright, not Jesus. Don't talk about Jesus. Leave him out. There was no room for him at the inn. Same thing today. Yes, there was no room at the inn, no room for him
mm-hmm.
at the inn. Keep him out. Peter and John answered and said unto them, whether it is right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge ye, for we cannot but speak those things which we do see and hear. And when they had further threatened them, name, just don't mention the name, anything else, talk about the bus ride is fine, talk about everything else, the food and fried chicken and the fried fish, and talk about that, fine. Talk about the music, good. Sing some ungodly, some kumbaya, Lord kumbaya, sing that, that's fine. Going up the rough side mountain, sing that too. But don't mention Jesus. Don't mention Jesus. Conspicuously absent. Don't mention Jesus. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 5. See what God is saying to us in his holy, written, precious word. Acts chapter 5. Jesus. Frightening. And it's the same thing today. And nothing changed. And nothing changed. Same thing today. Leave Jesus out. And if you just think about it, listen to some of the programs you listen to. As if you hear, if you mention just sort of passing way, you know, and Jesus passed sort of, you know, but he's not just sent to point the gun at Jesus, pointed at him, the name. You see? In the name of Jesus, stand up and walk. In the name of Jesus, in the name of, come out. Tell the evil, in the name of Jesus, come out. You see? Now, keep that name out. There's no other name under heaven. You must be saved. You give him a name that's above every name. We ought to use that name. Name of Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. They say, leave it out. Talk about everything else. Leave Jesus out. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 5. And look at verse 17. Acts chapter 5 and verse 17, the name. The name that's above every name. Acts chapter 5, verse 17. And see what God is saying to us there. And the high priest rose up, and all that were with him, which were the sect of the Sadducees, were filled with indignation, and laid their hands on the apostles, with an S, and put them into the common prison. Because see why they put them in the common prison? The apostles, God had set some in the church, first apostles, secondary prophet, thirdly, the highest ministry gave the apostles, put them in prison. And when the angel of the Lord by night opened the prison door and brought them forth and said, go and stand and speak to the temple, the people, all the words of this life. And when they heard that, they entered into the temple early in the morning and they taught. And the high priest came and they that were with him and called the council together, and all the senate and the children of Israel sent to the prison to bring them forth. And when the officers came, found them not in the prison, they returned and told, saying, the prison truly we found was shut with all safety, and the keeper standing without before the door. But when we had opened, we found no man within. And when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests, all people have nothing else to do, just for Jesus, mention him together. And when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests had heard these things, they doubted whereunto this would grow. And they came and one and told them, saying that, behold, the man whom you put in prison standing in the temple, teaching the people. And when the captain and the officers bore them without violence, for they feared the people, lest they should have been stoned, when they had bore them, they set them before the council, and the high priest asked them, saying, did not we straightly command you not to teach in... did we not command you not to teach in... talk about anything else, but don't mention the name. Did we look at verse 28? saying, did we not straightly command you not to teach in the name, in this name, that you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man blood upon us? Yeah. Did we not command, strictly command you not to teach in this name? Any other name, but not this name. Yeah, that's the name. And throughout you just turn about. You travel, as we travel into Africa, we travel into the Caribbean, we travel different places, different parts of this country. You same thing. Same religious spirit in the churches. Mm-hmm. You sit down there listening there, listen for the name of Jesus. These two men want to jump and take their lives. They listen to, let me hear if they're going to mention Jesus. And we mention, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. And they stop. Young man going out there, I'm baptized in water, I read granny Bible, I'm a member of the church. And they plunging into hell. Spirit leave the body one time and come back in. Leaving a second time, I'm a member of the church, I was baptized in water, read granny Bible. Second time, third time, the spirit leaving for the final time. Scream out. Member of the church, baptized in water, read granny Bible, Jesus! Spirit just grab him and put him back in his body. Jesus, keep the name out. Mm-hmm. They have done the Senate and all these high officials, ain't got nothing better to do. You could do what you want, but don't mention that one name. Any other name is fine. Mention Pilate, mention Herod, mention Governor Felix, all that fine. But don't mention Jesus. Don't mention Jesus. Any other name is fine. Talk about Herod, Pontius Pilate, and all the other bloodthirsty people. Talk about them. Don't mention Jesus. Look at it. Look at the 28th verse. Did we not straightly command you that you should not teach in this name? Any other name, fine, but not this name. Don't teach in this name. Don't teach in this name. Not this name. We're not having it. We're not having it. Look at the Apostle Paul on his way to Damascus. This is something. The name. Everybody's scared of the name. Scared of the name. And the church just stay quiet and following, instead of they dancing to your music, you dancing to their music. The name. The name. The name. Don't teach in this name. I have nothing better to do. Any other name, fine. If they had gone and hear them teaching something else, fine. But once you mention Jesus, you have some problems. You got some problems. Acts chapter 9, look at the Apostle Paul on his way to Damascus to persecute Christians. Now look at this. Look at this revelation. This part of it, not all of it, but this part of it. Acts chapter 9, thinking about verse 1. Saul, yet breathing out threatening and slaughter against the disciple of the Lord, went unto the high priest. Not the Lord priest, the high priest. To become a high priest, you have to go through some process. You don't just wake up one morning and become a high priest. The high priest. Desiring will let us to Damascus, to the synagogue, if he should find any this way, whether there were men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. Now, Christians were called the way, or this way, or that way. That's what they called the way. Verse 3. And as he journeyed, came near to Damascus, suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven. He fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? I'm Jesus, whom thou persecutest, hard for the king. Now, he doesn't even know who he persecuted. Look at it. Who art thou, Lord? I'm Jesus. Why persecutest thou me? Who art thou, Lord? He doesn't know who he persecuted. That he persecuted. He trembled and his son said, verse 6, What will thou have me to do? The Lord said, Rise and go into the city and shall tell you what thou must do. And the men which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice and seeing no man. And Saul arose from the earth. And when he had opened his eyes, he saw no man. And they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. He was there 3 days without sight, neither did he eat nor drink. And there's a certain disciple in Damascus named Ananias. To him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias, he said, Behold, I'm here, Lord. And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the street called Straight, and inquire in the house of one Judas for one Saul of Tarsus, for the holy prayed. He had seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming out to him and putting his hand in that he might receive his sight. And he answered, Lord, I've heard of many, this man, how much evil he had done to thy saints at Jerusalem. And here he had authority from the chief priests to bind all that call on thy name, all that call on the bishop, the apostle, the prophet. All that call on thy name. All that call on thy name. Look at that 14th verse. He had authority from the chief priests. And notice the priests have an S. All of them get together. All of them united. Chief priests with an S. To bind all that call on name. And the Lord said, Go thy way, for he's a chosen vessel and will bear my name before the Gentiles and the kings and the children of Israel. I'll show him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake. And Aeneas went in, is when entered into the house, putting his hand on him, and said, Brother Saul, Lord, even Jesus, appear unto thee as thou comest. sent me that thou might receive thy son, be full of the Holy Ghost. And immediately it fell from his eyes as had been scales, and received sight. Forthwith he arose and was baptized. When he received meat, straightway in certain days, and I preached and went to the disciples were Damascus, and straightway he preached Christ in the synagogue that he was the Son of God. But notice what called from thy scales fall from thy eyes. You know what those scales are? Denomination, religions, customs, denominations, all this. But all that call on their name. So all you have to do is to mention the name. He have authority from the chief priest that anybody call on the name of Jesus, lock them up, men or women. We got to read a little part of that again. We got to read a little part of that again. We got to read a part of that again. All that call, look at that. All that call, I'm not get authority from the chief priest, trapped all the way from Jerusalem to Damascus. Look at the distance. Going all there just to stop the name. Look at the distance. What's the distance? Get a map, some of you who do some homework in your home. Go on the map. Now you could get on this internet and you could search all kinds of. Look at the distance between Jerusalem and there. Paul is traveling all the way from Jerusalem, all the way to Damascus, for anybody call on the name. Let's read that again. Let's read that one more time. Look at verse 9. Look at chapter 9, verse 1. And as Saul breathing out threatening and slaughter against the disciple of the Lord, he went unto the high priest. And desire of him led us to Damascus, to the synagogue, all the way from Jerusalem. Look at the synagogue. If he found any this way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. And as he journey came near to Damascus, suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he answered and said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus whom thou persecutest. It's hard for thee to kick against the prick. And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said to him, Arise and go into the city, and I shall tell you what thou wantest to do. And the man which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice and seeing no man. Saul arose from the earth, and when his eyes were open, he saw no man, and they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And he was there 3 days without sight, neither to eat or drink. And there was a certain disciple of Damascus named Ananias. To him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias, he said, Behold, I'm here, Lord. And the Lord said to him, Arise and go into the street called Straight, and inquire of the house of one Judas for one Saul of Tarsus, for behold, he prayed. For he has seen a vision of man named Ananias coming and putting his hand in him that he might receive his sight. And he answered and said, Lord, I've heard of many of this man, how much evil have done to thy saints at Jerusalem, and here you have authority from the chief priests to bind all that call on thy name. To bind all that. So all the way from Jerusalem, all the way to Damascus in Syria, all the way there, to bind Christian because they mentioned Jesus. A new Christian doesn't see the light at the end of the tunnel, that the name is what make the devil and his crowd tremble. It's the name that opened the doors. It's the name that make the blind eye. The name that baptizes. The name that doeth. The name. Highly exalt him. Give him a name that's above every name. That name, every knee must bow to that name. Every tongue must confess to that name. And he get that name in three areas. Bestowal, conquest, inheritance. The name. Command them that they speak that name all the way there to make sure they don't mention the name. Buddha is fine, Hare Krishna is fine, Muhammad is fine, but don't mention the name, Jesus Christ. Don't mention that name. Don't mention that name. You mention that name. Every one of you that listen to the Christian, they call out Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. If you feel like your life, say Jesus, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. Don't say, oh God, that's not enough. Jesus is Lord. You see the name all the way there. Make sure you don't mention that name. Did I not command you to not teach in that name? The name. Yeah, I just going around, you know, hallelujah, I had a vision from God and the Holy Ghost. I know. There's a time for that, but the name. Whatsoever has the Father in my name, if two or more gather in my name, there's no other name under heaven where a man must be saved. No other name, none. And we look at there, all come from all over the world into Jerusalem. Everybody, what shall I do? Repent and call on the name for the remission of sin. Everybody from all over in Egypt and Libya and Cyrene and Pamphylia and all over the world, everybody have to call on that name, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Let's try to close off this with this. 1 Timothy. Hallelujah. 1 Timothy chapter 1. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, while I was cooking, I was eating myself. Jesus. 1 Timothy chapter 1. The name. All the way. Make sure you don't mention the name. Did I even not command you not speak in that name? Don't speak in the name. Anything else, but don't speak name. Talk about food and talk about the party. Talk about everything. Don't talk about the name. Don't mention the name. We have a name that's above every name. A name that's above every name. Don't mention the name. Don't mention the name. The name is conspicuously absent. Yeah, don't mention the name. Hallelujah. First Timothy chapter 1, and look at what Paul is saying here in this verse. First Timothy chapter 1, let's speak about the 12th verse. And I thank Jesus Christ our Lord, who had enabled me, that he counted me faithful, Hallelujah. Putting me into the ministry.
Yes.
Who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and an injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. How many people are doing it ignorantly in unbelief out there? In unbelief. And the grace of our Lord was exceedingly abundant with faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. And this is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of who I am chief. You know who is the chief? Number one. He came into the world, but look at it. He said, I did it ignorantly. Going about living all the way in Jerusalem to go all the way to anybody, just mention the way Jesus. You're under arrest. Any other name, fine. Don't mention Jesus. Any other name, fine. Don't mention Jesus. Look at those verses again. I thank Jesus Christ. Look at that few verses. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus. Look at those few verses. Like, this is where you get your cue from. Look how many times he mentioned Jesus, the Lord Jesus Christ. Look at it. Just a few verses. Look at those few verses. Watch that. I thank Jesus Christ our Lord, who had enabled me and called me faithful and put me into the ministry. Who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious person, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly and in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord was exceedingly abundant with faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. Which is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. And he said he's number one. Amen. But isn't that something? Mm-hmm. We think about the name.
The name is awesome.
Yes.
And you know what's so amazing? It's so much power.
Yeah.
In that name.
Yeah.
And the thing a lot of people don't understand, that is so much power in the name of Jesus. Mm. There's power because when you talk about the blood of Jesus.
Yeah, we do it next time with the blood. That's the next
okay.
time.
Okay. But blood. I'm just saying, just knowing the name that's above all names. Yes. Yeah. What can happen? That name could destroy every stronghold in your life, open up blind eyes, open up deaf ears, make the lame to walk.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Every day.
Just think about it. Sometimes I love it. I just walk around sometime and I just say, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Yeah.
When you think of that name.
Just walking up the stairs, just walking through the building.
Knowing
Jesus,
that,
Jesus.
Just knowing.
Just walking around the building, put your hand in the building, put your hand in the van, on the car, the trucks.
Yes.
Put your hand in all vehicles. Jesus. Walking to the sanctuary, just walking all through the sanctuary. Jesus.
God.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Just knowing power.
Yeah. Walking the sanctuary.
When you call on the name of Jesus.
Amen. Jesus.
Just when you, and you know, when you think about, when you call on that name, what it can do, the penetration. I mean, just think, lay hands on the sick in the name of Jesus.
Everything's in the name. Baptize in the name of Jesus. To the Father in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Crippled from my mother's womb.
God, thank you, Lord.
Save and will have I none such argument
thank you
in
for
the
that
name,
name
of Jesus. And you see, they fight it, they organized church fighting.
Yes.
Like command you not
God.
To speak like Paul, leaving all the way in Jerusalem.
Jesus,
look at the distance.
Jesus,
those of you listening, look at the distance.
Jesus.
Going all the anybody called the Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If they go to say Buddha, Hari Krishna, fine.
Hallelujah.
Don't mention Jesus. Bring them back bound in chains to Jerusalem because of just mentioning the name Jesus.
And I mean, when you look at it, that's where your power lies in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
But most people, a lot of times I hear people pray. They say these prayers and they be amen. I be like, they missed
whatsoever
it.
Whatsoever you ask the Father in my name.
My name, in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
And you know, honey, when you was reading that, you have to realize this. When it says, every knee shall bow. I don't care who you are,
what you
believe in, where you live at. You is going to bow to the name of Jesus.
Yeah. If you don't bow in this world, you bow in the next world.
Next world, yes.
Because everything in heaven, in earth, and under the earth have to bow to that name.
I have to.
You know? So I don't care how white you are, how black you are, how educated, how rich you think you are, you have to bow to that name.
Oh my God.
You don't bow it now,
power.
voluntarily, Hallelujah. Involuntarily, and drag you down. Every tongue would have to confess that He is Lord.
Thank you.
Do that, you see. And do it ignorantly. So I didn't call this name of Jesus Christ. That's very, very sad. Walk in the house. I mean, walk in the house. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Yes.
Throughout the house. You know, throughout the children sleeping at night, lay hands in the name of Jesus.
Jesus,
name of Jesus,
yes.
Name of Jesus. See, the body sleep, but the spirit never sleep.
Amen.
You see,
amen.
Sometimes you think they're younger, they can't hear. No,
they
the spirit can hear.
Yes.
Yeah, their body might be sleeping, your husband might be seeing your wife sleeping. Lay in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Walk all through your house. Jesus, you get in your car before you start your car. Pray in the name of Jesus. Name of Jesus. This car won't work. No accident. Nobody's going to get killed. Nobody's going to get hit with this car. In the name of Jesus, 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 Jesus. Nobody tell you what to say. Just talk. Yeah. We go to the restaurant sometime to eat. We eat the food. They're just cursing over the food.
Yeah.
And then we make a big circle of praying in the restaurant. They're looking at us and we're strange. They're strange.
They're strange.
You see that world over there think we're crazy. We know that they're crazy. They think we're crazy. We know that they're crazy.
You know, you said something. And for all you out there that are listening, you know, out there in radio land, when you get in your car or when you're on a train, when you're on a boat, anywhere you go that someone else is driving or yourself is driving, always pray. Always pray.
In the name.
In the name of Jesus, that the angels of the Lord is encamped about the vehicle that someone else is driving. Even when I get on a bus, I pray. Because I don't know where the driver is, but if I'm on this bus, when I ride the train, I pray. When I get in someone's car, I pray. When I eat my food, I pray. But I always end it in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but the Lord said I should just let people know.
Yes.
When anybody car you get in, when I get in a cab, I pray.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. This is so important. Amen. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to share that with you. Okay?
Amen.
God bless you.
We want to give those that are listening on radio, those that are viewing on radio also, this, however it's going, fire, go and give an opportunity to receive Jesus the Lord. Say, we don't know where you are spiritually. We
Amen.
Don't know how many days you have in your land of living. We don't know what contract you have, covenant you have with God. So we want to make sure that you're saved. You have no business being the kingdom of darkness. Jesus says, not my wish that any should perish. And hell wasn't made for you, it was made for the devil and the angels.
Amen.
We want to give you an opportunity. If you're already saved, stand proxy for somebody. Some of us have families on the Caribbean, in Africa, in Asia, in different parts of the States. So you want to stand proxy if you're already saved. Repeat these words, I mean, from the bottom of your heart. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
You said in your holy words.
You said in your holy words.
Whosoever come to me.
Who should ever come to me.
I'll in no way cast out.
I will no way cast out.
But I'll take them in.
But I'll take them in.
So I come to you.
So I come to you.
You didn't cast me out.
You didn't cast me
but
out.
But you took me in.
But you took me in.
And I thank you.
And I thank you.
Romans 10.
Romans 10.
Verse 13.
Verse 13.
Whosoever call upon the name of the Lord.
Who should ever call upon the name of the Lord.
Shall be saved.
Shall be saved.
So I call upon your name.
So I call upon your name.
So I'm now saved.
So I'm now saved.
Romans 10.
Romans 10.
Verses 9 and 10.
Verses 9 and 10.
With the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
With the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
But with the heart man believe it unto righteousness.
But with the heart man believe it unto righteousness.
So I confess with my mouth.
So I confess with my mouth.
The Lord Jesus.
The Lord Jesus.
That he died.
That he died.
Went to hell.
Went to hell.
Spent 3 days.
Spent 3 days.
And 3 nights.
And 3 nights.
Just for me.
Just for me.
Because I confess that with my mouth.
Because I confess that with my mouth.
And I believe that in my heart.
And I believe that in my heart.
I'm now saved.
I'm now saved.
I now become the righteousness.
The righteousness
of God.
Of God.
In Christ.
In Christ.
2 Corinthians.
2 Corinthians.
5:21.
5:21.
Jesus.
Jesus.
You represent me in heaven.
You represent me in heaven.
And I will.
And I will.
Represent you on earth.
Represent you on earth.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I thank you.
I thank you.
For what you did for me.
For what you did for me.
On Calvary.
On Calvary.
Shedding your blood.
Shedding your blood.
To redeem me.
To redeem me.
From the curse of the Lord.
From the curse of the Lord.
Spiritual death.
Spiritual death.
Poverty.
Poverty.
And sickness.
And sickness.
Satan.
Satan.
You're no longer my Lord.
You're no longer my Lord.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Is my Lord.
Is my Lord.
And my Savior.
And my Savior.
I'll live for him.
I'll live for him.
I'll serve him.
I'll serve him.
I'll study his words.
I'll study his words.
I'll be a good example.
I'll be a good example.
For all to see.
For all to see.
And I thank you.
And I thank you.
In your name I pray.
In your name I pray.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Glory to God. Wonderful. Give it up a heart. Hallelujah. The Bible said that man shall not live by bread alone, by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. What he's saying, what food is to your physical body? The word of God is the spirit. So you need to feed your spirit as you feed your body. As you feed your body 3 times, you need to feed your spirit. Christianity is not passive but active. The Bible said when an unclean spirit has gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places seeking rest, and finally coming back. come back and find the house empty, sweep and garnish. You're going to get seven more, three more wicked himself, come back to dwell there, and your last, it is worse than your first. So you don't want to do that. You want to find time to read your Bible every day. Don't let that house stay empty and just do nothing. You want to make sure you read it three times a day. I want to suggest start with the Gospel according to John, because he speaks about love more than the other. All of them speak about love because God is love. But start with him, and don't try to read the whole Bible in one day. Read one chapter, chew on it for a while, then this midday again, do it the next day, read it, and then you build up after this, build up some steam, so God going to lead you to move to other things. But start small, aim tall, and have yourself a ball as you go and do these things. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we're out of time now. Father, we just thank you for this time that you've given us. Thank you for the opportunities, yes, and privileges. Thank you for your son, Jesus, who make all this possible. We give you all the praise, all honor, and all glory, because all belong to you. In Jesus' name, amen,
amen. And amen.
Good night.
You have been listening to Pastor Randolph Ferdinand, teachings from the Word. To get a copy of this teaching or any of the other series, call 347-533-4271. 347-533-4271. Or visit the Christian Community Center at 326 Junior Street in Brooklyn. That is 326 Junior Street in Brooklyn. Sunday worship, 9:30, 10:30, and 12:30. Bible study, 6:30 p.m. on Monday nights. Like us on Facebook or YouTube at H2C3 Ministry. H2C3 Ministry. Go for the Word.
On the high waters, it's time again to lift up the name of Jesus in praise underwater. The second edition of Praise Underwater, Labor Day. The name that is above every name will be lifted on high aboard the Golden Sunshine. Pier 2, Emmons Avenue, Shipshed Bay. Live in the dock at 9 a.m. sharp, so boarding time must be 8 a.m. Labor Day Monday, get ready for the biggest cruise underwater. Bringing on the praise, more than a conqueror, Janis Charles. It will be praise of fire. Praise of fire.
Everybody man your post. Get filled with the Holy Ghost.
Also appearing live is the anointed one from St. Lucia, Brother Emerald.
If you have a talent,
praise on the water. Look star.
That's why I can sing songs like amazing.
Making a special guest appearance is Michael Prince, and a surprise performer will perform. Brace yourself, saints of God. You would never leave the same way you came. It's gonna be Praise Underwater. Get your tickets now. Children under 13, you pay $25. Adults, you pay $45. Tickets available at Tasty Parties, 3122 Church Avenue, between East 31st and East 32nd Street. Bruce's Party is 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and 96th Street. Or buy your tickets online from www.choicegospelnetwork.com or call 646-436-5599, 347-663-8638, or 347-443-5473. We are serving your free food with the best DJs. Brother Edwin, Bishop Anderson, 007, Pastor Green, Minister Glenn, and more. This Labor Day Monday morning, we are sailing for Jesus on the Golden Sunshine.